Hello dear friends, welcome to the lecture of numerical methods. In this lecture we shall study Hermite's interpolation formula. Earlier we have studied Newton's interpolation formula for backward difference and also for forward difference. Also Lagrange interpolation formula we have studied. Now we will study Hermite's interpolation formula. We will obtain the formula, derivation of the formula. I have written first few part of this, what is considered in or when Hermite's interpolation formula is used. Suppose we have given the set of data points xi, yi and yi prime or yi dash. So this means y is a function of x and yi dash is the derivative of yi. So derivative values are also given at this point xi. The three values are there. X value, corresponding value of y, and then its derivative also is given for I taking value 0, 1, 2 up to n. And then we want to find a polynomial of least degree, say that is denoted by h, h stands for Hermite, h 2n plus 1, this is the degree of the polynomial, h 2n plus 1 of x. Now what is the degree of this least degree of the polynomial is written as 2n plus 1, because here see, if you see how many points are there, I takes value 1 to n, so that means I takes value 0 to n, 0, 1 up to n, that means these are n plus 1 values. So therefore here yi will take the values n plus 1 values and x also will take n plus 1 values, so that will be n plus 1. So this will be n plus 1, that the values of x values will be there, and again n plus 1 values are there for y, and thus the total values will be 2n plus 2, but the degree of the polynomial is 1 less than this, and therefore the degree of the polynomial will be 2n plus 1. So thus Hermite's polynomial will be of degree 2n plus 1. Earlier we have in Newton's interpolation formula, we have considered only the values of yi, and there the values of yi were n plus 1, and therefore the polynomial corresponding will be of degree n. But here there are two values given, corresponding value of x, the two values of two set of values, that is yi n plus 1 values and yi dash n plus 1 values. So it becomes 2n plus 2, and the degree will be one number less, means 2n plus 1. So it is the polynomial, and we will consider here h 2n plus 1 of xi is equal to yi. That means the order pair here, the value of polynomial at xi is equal to yi, and further the derivative of h at xi is denoted by yi prime. So thus this h of xi is yi and h dash of xi is yi dash, that as earlier also we have denoted this y of xi is equal to yi, and that means y at x naught is equal to y naught, y at x1 is equal to y1. This notation we have used earlier also for Newton's formula and Lagrange formula. I takes values 0, 1, 2, so on up to n. And this h 2n plus 1 of x is called Hermite's interpolation polynomial. As in Newton's interpolation polynomial, we have denoted it by y n x. Lagrange interpolation polynomial, we have denoted by ln x. And we will denote the Hermite interpolation polynomial by h 2n plus 1. And it is of degree 2n plus 1. We determine h 2n plus 1 of x in this form. This is the form of the polynomial we have considered, that means in two parts. The first part is in terms of yi, and the second part is yi dash. So here h 2n plus 1 of x is summation I takes value 0 to n. These are the values of I from 0 to n. Ui of x into yi. This is the product of this function we have considered. We are determining, that means we are assuming the form of the Hermite polynomial in this form, and then we will find out what is this function ui and function vi. Yi and yi dash are the given values. So this is written as a summation I takes value 0 to n ui of x into yi plus summation I takes value 0 to n vi of x into yi dash or yi prime. So this is what we have assumed the polynomials for, and then we want to find ui and vi. So what is ui? Because h 2n plus 1 is a polynomial of degree 2n plus 1, and this yi is a constant value, yi dash is also a value, particular value. So therefore these are the polynomials. Ui x and vi x are polynomials, and their degree must be same as the degree of the left side polynomial. So that means ui of x and vi of x are the polynomials of x, polynomials in x of degree same, 2n plus 1. Now further, what we are going to do is from this relation, so we have assumed the polynomial in this form. Now we can replace x by any value of x. There are n plus 1 values of x, n plus 1 values of yi, and n plus 1 values, corresponding values of yi dash. So we can replace this x by xj. So I have written here the from 3, replacing x by xj, we have the same equation or relation is written like this: to h 2n plus 1 xj is equal to x is replaced by xj, and here ui of xj into yi, there is no change in yi and yi prime. So vi of xj into yi dash. Now what will be the value of this expression? Now here we have assumed h 2n plus 1 of xi is equal to yi, and therefore what will be h 2n plus 1 of xj? So that must be equal to yj. From this is written by 1, so this is simply yj. So the meaning of this, so h, suppose h, this will be odd numbers 2n plus 1, so h 5 of x I, that is x 7 will be equal to y 7, that is the meaning. So thus this must be equal to yj. If here it is xi, then the image of this xi under this polynomial is y, or value is yi. So this is equal to yj. So if this is equal to yj, when this sum of n plus 1 terms, and this is also sum of n plus 1 terms, will be equal to yj. So that gives, this will imply. Now see, if you put I is equal to j, then here it will get the yj term, and its coefficient must be 1 when I is equal to j. So this implies, ui of xj is equal to, so this will be 1 in the case I is equal to j, because we must get the coefficient of, we put in this expression, in this sum, the sum is from 0 to n, that means first term will be u naught x xj y naught plus I is 1 u 1 xj, j will remain the same, y 1 plus, and so on. So in that case this will be, or if I write here that expression, this expression here, then it is first term is u naught xj y naught plus u1 xj y1 plus, so on, and the last one will be un, I is n, un xj yn. So this is the expression, and we are putting this is simply yj, and that means j will be one number between 0 to n. So here it will be uj xj yj, some number is intermediate, and only this relation will hold if this all are 0 except this one. So remaining will be 0, and here what is the case, uj xj is 1, means the coefficients here, the suffix of u and suffix of x, if they are equal, then it is 1. Otherwise if they are unequal, here it is u naught xj, these are different, u1 xj, so this suffixes are different, then the value is 0, and if the suffixes are equal, then the value is 1, then and only then we will get this is equal to yj, because this will be equal to 1, and 1 into yj, and remaining are all 0. So from this term only we will get yj. And what about the second term? This must be 0 for all values of x. Then and only then this, the term of derivative y dash is not there. Only we want this term, and therefore this must be 0. So this is the implication of the equality, this equality. So these two are equal imply ui xj has two values. So this is, we have as considered here, it is 1 if I and j are equal, these two suffixes are equal, it is 1. And 0 if these two suffixes are different. So that we are going to write, and this is important, you should note it. So ui xj is 1 if I is equal to j, and this is 0 if I is not equal to j. So this is the function which can be considered as orthonormal function. So if the two suffixes are equal, its value is 1, and if they are unequal, its value is 0. So for example, if I write u1 of x2, then that is 0 because 1 and 2 are different. So which will be 1? U1 of x1 will be 1, u3 of x3 will be 1, etc. If these two are equal, then its value is 1. So that is simple. And if these are unequal, the value is 0. So that is the implication of then and only then this will be give only single term yj. And what this second term, this is vi is 0. Yi dash are given values, so they may not be 0, and therefore this must be 0 for each value. And from the second part, and vi of x, vi of x is equal to 0 for all I, all I, irrespective of I is equal to j or not. If they are equal, then also it is 0. So each term of vi is 0. And we shall suppose this as relation 4 or equation 4. Now what we will do is, one relation we have obtained by taking h2n plus 1 of xj. Now we will differentiate this, differentiate 3, and then use the second relation to get another equation. So we will write further, differentiating 3 with respect to x. We get, now see what we shall get. We are differentiating it with respect to x. So these are functions of x, and these are constant values, will remain the same. Yi is the value given in the table or in the data, and therefore these are constant values, it will remain the same. We have to only differentiate ui x and vi x, and thus this can be written as h dash means derivative of h with respect to x, h dash 2n plus 1 of x is equal to sigma I takes value 0 to n, and this is ui dash x yi plus sigma I takes value 0 to n vi dash or vi prime x yi dash. So this we shall get, and as like this, replace x by xj to get a relation. So this implies, therefore, replacing x by xj, we get, this gives h 2n plus 1, h dash of 2n plus 1 at xj. Wherever x is there, see, at three places, x, here it is x, and here it is x. Replace x by xj. This relation will true for any value of x, and therefore it is true for xj, and that is summation I takes value 0 to n, it is ui dash xj yi plus summation I takes value 0 to n vi dash xj at xj yi dash. So this relation we have obtained. Now we will make use of second. Now this is h dash of 2n plus 1 of xi is equal to yi dash for I taking value 1 to n. And in place of xi, we have written here xj. So its value must be yj dash. In place of xj, xi, here it is xj. So result must be yj dash from this second. So this is equal to yj prime by second. This is at xj, so its value is yj prime by 2. So thus we have obtained similar to this relation. We have used one there, and that h of xj is yj, h dash of xj is yj dash. So this is by 2. Now this sum implies this sum is equal to yj dash. So what that will imply? So this will imply, as we have written here. So this implies now you see the derivative term is remaining. So this is 0. So whatever may be the value of ui dash, so the whatever may be the value of I and j, this term is always 0, because there is no term of yi, and therefore all these terms are 0. And yi cannot be 0, or yi may not be 0, because it is a data values. So this must be 0, means every ui dash is 0. So that this implies first is ui dash at x is equal to 0 for all I. For all I may be equal to j or may not be equal to j. And what is second? Now what will be this yi dash becomes yj dash. And here as we have seen here itself. See y, this term when is equal to yj, if I and j are equal, then yi becomes yj. And here when I and j are equal, its value is 1. So in place of that term, here it is vi prime. So this term must be 1 when j is equal to I. And that means vi dash of xj is equal to. So this is 1 if I is equal to j. And otherwise it is 0, because there are n plus 1 terms. Only 1 is non-zero. In that case, these two are equal, it is 1. And other cases, that means these two are unequal, it is 0. As we have seen here, it can be expanded and can be verified. So it is 0 if I is not equal to j. Thus, we have obtained this type of relation between ui dash for ui dash and vi dash. And we will suppose this together as 5, because we are going to use this further. We want to determine ui and vi for this. And now we will assume li of x. Now let li of x is a polynomial of degree n. Is a polynomial. This polynomial we have actually used in Lagrange interpolation formula. Be a polynomial of degree n given by li of x is equal to. The terms are x minus x naught. There are x values are x naught up to xn, and therefore this is x minus x naught, x minus x1, so on, x minus. Here we have to exclude the term xi. We don't write the term x minus xi, and we write all the remaining terms, like x minus that term, x minus first term, x minus x1, x minus x2, but don't write x minus xi. So we don't write x minus xi term. So this is to be discarded from this product. And if this is discarded, we have to write the earlier term and the next term. So So what is the earlier term? X minus x I minus 1. And the next term will be x minus x I plus 1, next suffix. So only x minus x I is between this, and that is deleted. And further it is continued up to x minus x n. This is the numerator. And denominator is replace each x in these brackets by x I. Here I is the suffix. So this first term becomes x I minus x naught. Second becomes x I minus x 1, and so on. This becomes x I minus x I minus 1, and this is x I minus x I plus 1, and so on. The last will be x I minus x n. See this. How we have written L of x. Here this term is deleted from numerator, and for the denominator, the first term x is replaced by xi in each bracket. That is to be noted. Two things: x minus xi is not at the numerator, and at denominator each x is replaced by xi. So for example, if I write say L2 of x, then this will be so x minus x2 term must not be there, and the first term is x minus x naught, x minus x1, and x minus x2 is not there, means we have to write x minus x3, and so on up to x minus xn, divided by, and what is the denominator? Denominator will be, so this is for example I am writing, and denominator will be each x is to be replaced by x2. So x2 minus x0, x2 minus x1, x2 minus x3, and so on up to x2 minus xn. See, this is for example only. Now see what this will imply. So when if I write L2 of x2, so what will be its value? So L2 of x2 will be, if then that x becomes x2, so x2, x, each x becomes x2, and in this case the numerator and denominator are equal, and therefore the value of the expression is 1. So this is 1. So that means here x is replaced by xi. If x is replaced by xi, the numerator becomes xi minus x0, xi minus x1, xi minus, and so on, xi minus xn. And the denominator is the same, xi minus x0. So the value is 1. That means when these two suffixes I and the suffix of x are equal, then the value is 1. It is the same thing like this. If I and j are equal, the value is 1. So same is the case for Li xj, and we will write that also. So this implies, so I shall write that expression here, this imply. So we have to remember this for ui and vi. So there is no need to write this expression, this is for understanding I have written. This imply Li xj is equal to 1 if I is equal to j, 0 if I is not equal to j. You should verify this, and we will suppose this relation as 6. This relation we shall suppose as 6. Now for example, if these two are different, why it becomes 0? If I consider L2 of x1, see here itself, L2 of x1, then each x is to be replaced by x1, and here what will happen? If I replace x by x1, the second term is becomes 0. One term becomes 0 because the values becomes equal here, x1 minus x1, and therefore if this term is 0, the whole expression becomes 0. That means if I is not equal to j, the value of this function Li xj is 0. So thus we have this. Now we shall suppose the polynomial we have earlier written. We want to determine this polynomial, that is h2n plus 1, and to determine this polynomial we want uix and vix. So these are the polynomials of degree 2n plus 1, and what is Li? Li is polynomial of degree n. So we now express this ui x as, now let ui of x and vi of x polynomials, these are the polynomials. Now the polynomials, you can say the ui and vi are polynomials, are polynomials of degree n plus 1, 2n plus 1. Therefore, we can write, and Li is of degree n. So therefore, we can write like this. Therefore, we can write ui x is equal to a polynomial. So I shall consider a polynomial, linear polynomial of first degree, and that polynomial I shall write as ai x plus bi into li x whole square. See how it is. Now what is the degree of this polynomial? 2n plus 1, that we have written. And what is degree of li? Is n. So this the left side is this is a square, and therefore its degree will be 2n. It is a square, li x square, and li x is a polynomial of degree n, power is n, and it is again raised to 2, means the degree becomes 2n, and its degree is 1. So this is, and there will be addition of the degrees. So one, the total degree on the right side becomes 1 plus 2n, which is the degree of this polynomial ui x. So I think this is clear, because if I write li x is a quadratic polynomial, x square plus x plus 1, and if you raise the power, so what is the polynomial of this, the degree of this, this its degree becomes 2 into 2, and its degree is it is multiplied by 2x plus 3, the degree is 1. So thus the total degree of the whole expression is 1 plus 2 into 2, that is 2n plus 1. And similarly, we can write vi of x is equal to ai bi, are the constant terms we have to determine. We have to actually determine ai and bi. So vi of x, we can write ci into x plus di. Why we are considering like this? To match the degree on both sides. So this is a first degree polynomial. First degree polynomial is written ax plus b, but there are different terms. I takes values 0 to n. So therefore, in place of a and b, we are writing ai and bi. Similarly, here we use another letters ci and di multiplied by li of x whole square. And we may suppose this as 7 and 8. Next equations. Now we want to determine aix plus bi, and to determine this we shall make use of this relation. Earlier we have the relation for uix, and we can replace this by x is to be replaced by xj. What we shall get from 7, we will get 7 and 8 replacing x by xj, and we have these relations 4, 5, 6 we have to remember. Now I shall write further part here. Now from 7 and 8, replacing x by xj, what we will have is ui xj is equal to, right side is ai xj plus bi. Only x is to be replaced by xj, and in bracket that is li xj whole square, square of this, it must be written correctly. And what is the second relation? And second will be vi xj is equal to ci xj plus di, इंटू एल आई एक्स जे होल स्क्वेयर. सो दिस इज वॉट वी हैव ऑब्टेंड. बट वी सी दिस इम्प्लाइज or these imply, these together will imply, these imply, or these gives these give. What about this ui xj we have written earlier? The relation we have is equation number 4 that we have written. See, what we have is equation 4, ui xj is 1, I is equal to j, 0, I is not equal to j, and we have there vi, vi of x is 0 for all i, that is the relation we have. And here we have this type of relations. So this was written earlier as equations 4. Now we make use of this equation here. So ui xj, when I is equal to j or j is equal to I, it is 1. So this becomes 1. We are putting now j is equal to I. So this gives 1 is equal to 1 is equal, putting I, j is equal to I, it is 1. And we put j is equal to I, means right side is ai xi. We are using this. When j is equal to I, this term becomes 1. And right side also we have to put j is equal to I plus bi. Whenever, wherever x is there, we have to change j by x, j by I, and into bi. Into, now when li and this j becomes I, li of xi, see the relation. Here also the same relation is there. When I is equal to j, it is 1. So therefore it becomes 1, and that is 1 square. So this gives by 4 and 6. So this relation we will get. This we have used. 4 we have used on the left side, and 6 we have used on the right side. Both are 1. So only ai xi plus bi will remain. And therefore there is no need to write the bracket for this. And what the second is, and what about vi xj? So vi, so this is 0 for all I, whether I equal to j or not. So therefore this is 0 by 4, and right side is, so we will write ci xi. We are putting j is equal to I in these relations. So ci xi plus di, because we want this to be 1 and this is 1. So this is the second relation that we have obtained. And we may suppose this as next number we will write. Up to 8 we have written. Now we will write this as 9. So thus this we have obtained the relation. Now we should remember this 6 again we are going to use further. So li xi is 1, I is equal to j. So these three relations are we are using many times. And now what we will do is, we will differentiate this. We will differentiate this to these two equations, and to get the relation that we will use fifth relation. To use fifth equations, we differentiate these two. And for that purpose, we can write further. Differentiating this, now we have we may suppose these as 10, and differentiating 10, and we shall suppose this as 11. Differentiating 10 with respect to x, we get. Now see the derivative. Here we will denote the derivative by ui dash at x. So differentiating, so there is a earlier relation that we have to differentiate, 9 relation from our 7 and 8 we should write. Differentiating 7 and 8 in place of 11. So these numbers are earlier, Correct. There is no need to give a number for this. This is a particular value. So we have to, we should not differentiate this. We should differentiate the earlier relation, that is 7 and 8. Differentiate 7 and 8 with respect to x, we get. And this number given is 9, that is right. So we get, what is the derivative of this? I shall now assume this is x. So that equation, here it is, 7 and 8. Differentiate this with respect to x. So what is the derivative? Ui prime x, u or ui dash of x is, use the product rule for this. And if you use the product rule, derivative of this is ai only. Bi are actually constants. So, and therefore, this will be ai only. The derivative of first is ai, and second as it is, that will be li x whole square. Now, the first as it is into derivative of second. What is derivative of li x whole square? By power function formula, 2 into li of x into derivative of li of x, and that will be plus 2 into this term as it is, ai x plus bi li of x into derivative of that li dash of x. So this much is the derivative of 7. And what is the derivative of 8? It is exactly similar. In place of ai bi, there is only cidi, and that will be vi dash at x is equal to, we will have ci in bracket li x whole square plus 2 ci x plus di li of x li dash of x. So these are the derivatives. Now if you replace x by xj, see what will that gives. Now we do this step directly. Here we have written replace x by xj and then use 4 and 6 we have used. Now we will use 5th. Now when x is xj, replacing x by xj in this, we get, replacing x by xj and using 5 and 6. So what was the 6th equation? 6th equation we have written earlier, that are for li. Li of xj is 1 when I is equal to j, 0 when I is not equal to j. So these two relations we have to use. And we read xj here, ui dash xj, and ui dash here, that is 0. We have ui dash is 0 for every value, and therefore the first relation is 0. So this gives, I shall write here, or we need these equations further. So I will write here, and see, we get the first is 0. Ui dash is 0, and on the right we replace j is equal to I, or I is equal to j, but you see here it is I itself, xj, x by xj. So this xj and li, when they are equal, then I is equal to j, then it is 1. So this value becomes 1. We are replacing x by xj and taking this j is equal to I. So that is ai, right side is ai, this is 1, and plus 2 ai x plus bi. But you see ai xi, x is to be replaced by xi, or we in place of this we may write xi, taking this as xi, replacing x by xi. So this is 1, ai xi plus 2 into ai xi plus bi, and this is li xi, that is 1, and this will be li dash xi. So this value is 1 because li of xi is 1, x is replaced by xi. So this is one relation that we have obtained. And the second, what is vi dash xi? vi dash xi when j is equal to I. So these two are equal, it is 1. So therefore this will be 1. 1 is equal to, and right side is c1 and li xi is 1 by this. So that is 1 square, and 1 square is 1. So this is 1 and plus 2 ci xi plus di, 2 into ci xi plus di, and this is 1 and this is li dash xi. So this is the relation we have obtained, and we have used these two fifth, and this was the sixth equation. So we have used there. Now we can combine, use 9 here. So that is a 0 is equal to, this gives 0 is equal to ai, right side is ai plus, what is ai xi plus bi? Ai xi plus bi is 1. So that is 2 into 1 and li dash xi by 9. Using this value is 1, and now by 9 this value is 0. C1 that is 1 is equal to, 1 is equal to ci, it is not C1 but ci, this is ci, and 1 is equal to ci, and this is 0. So that we have obtained. From this we shall get the value of bi. So what is the value of bi from 9 again? Bi is, from 9, bi is equal to, see, 1 minus ai xi, 1 minus ai xi. And what is the ai xi? See, from this we can get ai is equal to minus 2 li dash xi. And that is equal to 1 minus, see, ai is, it is negative, and that negative of negative will be positive. So this will imply negative ai is equal to 2 li xi, and therefore it is plus 2 li dash at xi, li dash at xi. So this is the value of bi. And from this ci xi plus di is 0. So what is the ci value? Ci is 1. And what about di? Di is from 9. Di is equal to minus ci xi. And ci is 1. So therefore it is minus xi. So this is the value. And what about the value of ai? So ai is that we must write ai also from this. So this implies ai is equal to, take this on left side, that is minus 2 li dash xi. So thus we have written the value of ai, bi and ci and di, and we want to use these values in this relation that gives ui x and vi x. So we put these values. So you verify how we have calculated the values of these coefficients. These are actually coefficients ai, bi, and now we are going to use it in 7 and 8. So putting these values in 7 and 8. Using these values in our expressions in 7 and 8 we get. Now see what we shall get is the relation. First relation is ui of x. Ui of x is equal to ai, what is ai? Is here minus 2 li dash xi. Minus 2 li dash at xi. it is ai multiplied by x. So I shall write x earlier. So that is minus 2 into x into li dash, and then plus bi. Plus bi, what is bi? Bi is this much, 1 plus 2 li dash xi. So this is what is AIX plus BI multiplied by LIX whole square. And now you see this can be simplified. Here 1 we write first, 1 plus, and from these two we can take 2 common, 2 also and LI dash also common. So what remains in bracket, that is 2, and this is see here it is x remains, negative x, and here 1 is there. So it is x, 2 li dash, we will see bi value is bi is 1 minus ai into xi. So that here we have to write xi just to be corrected. You see the value of negative ai is 2 li dash xi in multiplied by xi. So this is to be multiplied by xi, and that is to be used here. So this is the correction, and thus this is the value of bi is 2xi into li dash at xi. And now if you take common this li dash xi, then in bracket what remains is xi minus x. So that is, or if you can write negative sign common, minus 2 common, then it will be x minus xi, and then it is multiplied by li dash at xi. You can verify this. We have combined these two and we have taken minus 2 common, so in bracket x minus xi remains, and this as it is li x whole square is the same. So this is what is ui of x. And vi of x is equal to, now see ci, what is ci? Ci is 1, so it is x only. And what is di? Di is minus xi. So it is x minus xi and into the same li x whole square. Li x whole square. So thus we have obtained the values of ui and vi. Now finally we substitute these values of ui and vi in the Hermite's polynomial. So that gives the Hermite's interpolation formula. So substituting these in 3, we get h2n plus 1 of x is equal to sigma I takes value 0 to n ui of x. Ui is here, it is 1 minus 2 in bracket x minus xi multiplied by li dash at xi, and this expression is multiplied further by li of x. Remember here is xi, but here it's only x whole square, plus summation I takes value 0 to n vi of x is here x minus xi into li of x whole square. So this is the Hermite's interpolation formula, so that we have obtained. So you should verify the steps how we have considered. We first assume the Hermite interpolation polynomial in this form, and then we have tried to determine ui and vi with the help of li, and these are orthonormal functions. When I is equal to j, then its value is 1, and for li also, li of and ui of xj also. And v for that is derivative v dash of v dash I of xj also. So that means 4, 5, 6 equations are same type, and using these we have obtained the values of uix, vix, and finally putting this in 3 we get this as the Hermite's interpolation formula. Now we will consider the problems on this in our next lecture. Thank you. But you see, observe the third relation. We have substituted the value of ui, we have to substitute value of ui and vi, but that is to be multiplied by yi, and therefore we must multiply this term by yi. So it is remaining to write, this term is to be multiplied by yi and this term is to be multiplied by yi dash. So then this is the correct form of the Hermite's interpolation formula. You please note this, we have to multiply ui, so this much is ui that we have written, it is to be multiplied by yi, and this much is vi, is to be multiplied by yi dash. So please note, and this is the Hermite's interpolation formula. Thank you.